मॉर्निंग बेटा, टुडे वी हैव टू डिस्कस मेजरमेंट ऑफ कोरिलेशन इन केस ऑफ ग्रुप डेटा विद द हेल्प ऑफ कार्ल पियर्सन्स कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ कोरिलेशन। आई हैव ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन यू मेजरमेंट ऑफ कोरिलेशन इन केस ऑफ अनग्रुप डेटा विद द हेल्प ऑफ कार्ल पियर्सन्स कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ कोरिलेशन। व्हाट इज ग्रुप डेटा? व्हेन यू आर गिवन टू सीरीज एक्स एंड वाई अलॉन्ग विद देयर फ्रीक्वेंसीज, दैट मीन्स if the value of x lies in between 40 to 50 and value of y lies in between 40 to 50, then these type of cases are three in number. And y lies in between 40 to 50 and x lies in between 50 to 60, these type of cases are five in number in your data. Similarly, y in between 40 to 50, x in between 60 to 70, then number of cases are 4. Y in between 60 to 70 and x 40 to 50, the number of cases are 19 and so on. How will you solve this data? How will you solve coefficient of correlation in this data with the help of Carl Pearson's coefficient of correlation? First of all, you will take the mid values of x as well as mid values of y. You know how to calculate the mid values? 40 plus 50 divided by 2. That means lower limit. Formula for mid value is lower limit plus upper limit divided by 2. 40 plus 50 divided by 2, 45. 50 plus 60 divided by 2, 55. 60 plus 70 divided by 2, 65. 70 plus 80 divided by 2, 75, and so on. Similarly, you can calculate mid values for y. 40 plus 50 divided by 2, 45. 50 plus 60 divided by 2, 55, and so on. Now you have to calculate dx. Dx is x minus assumed mean. I will take any value out of these values as an assumed mean. Let it be 65. I have taken 65 in this data. Then for the x series, then the values for dx will be 45 minus 65 minus 20, then 55 minus 65 minus 10, 65 minus 65 0, 75 minus 65 10, 85 minus 65 20, and so on. Then you have to calculate d dash x if there is any common factor. Here 10 is the common factor. All the values are divisible by 10. So I will divide all the values by 10 and I will take common factor as 10. We know that correlation is independent of change of origin as well as change of scale. That is, if I will subtract a common value from all the values, then it will not affect the value of correlation. Similarly, if I will divide or multiply a common value to all the values of series, then coefficient of correlation will not be affected. Now d dash x will be minus 20 divided by 2, minus 2, minus 10 divided by, minus 20 divided by 10, minus 2, minus 10 divided by 10, minus 1, 0 divided by 10, 0, 10 divided by 10, 1, 20 divided by 10, 2, and so on. D dash x square will be square of all these values. Minus 2 square 4, minus 1 square 1, 0 square 0, 1 square 1, 2 square 4, 3 square 9. Similarly, you can calculate dy as well as d dash y square. Dy will be, if I take assumed mean as 75, then dy will be 45 minus 75 minus 30, 55 minus 75 minus 20, 65 minus 75 minus 10, and so on. And d dash y will be dy divided by common factor as I have calculated in case of x. Similarly, we will calculate in case of y. Here again, the common factor is 10. D dash y will be minus 30 divided by 10, minus 3, minus 20 divided by 10, minus 2, minus 10 divided by 10, minus 1, so on. D dash y square will be 9, 4, 1, 0, 1, 4, right? Then we will calculate f d dash y. How we will calculate f d dash y? This is total of frequencies of y, that is 3 plus 5 plus 4, that is 12. It is simple. whatever the frequencies you are given in data, add all that frequencies row wise as well as column wise. Row wise total will be frequencies for y, and column wise total will be frequencies of x. 3 plus 5 plus 4, 12. 3 plus 6 plus 6 plus 2, 17, and so on. These are frequencies of y. I will take it as frequencies of y. And these are frequencies of x. That means values of the series which are given horizontally, then total horizontal total will be frequency for that series. Frequency of x, here it is frequency of y. Now I will multiply these frequencies with this d dash y. Multiply all the frequencies with respective d dash y. 12 minus 3 minus 36, 17 minus 2 minus 34, 21 minus 1 minus 21, 24 multiplied by 0, 0, 16 multiplied by 1, 16. That means values of this d dash y and value of y. All the respective values are multiplied and we will find out this f d dash y. Now what is f d dash y square? It is multiplication of this frequency with d dash y square. That is 12 into 9, 108. Then next one is 17 into 4, 68. Then 21 into 1, 21, then 24 into 0, 24, 16 into 1, 16, 10 into 4, 40. Then we will calculate f d dash x in the similar way. These are the frequencies of x. Then 7 into d dash x. Respective d dash x is minus 2. 7 into minus 2, minus 14. 15 into minus 1. This is minus 15. 25 into respective d dash x, 0. This is 0. Then 23 into respective d dash x, 1. This is 23, and so on. Similarly, we will calculate f d dash x square. Frequency is 7, and respective d dash x square is 4. 7 into 4, it is 28. Then 15 into 1, it is 15, then 0. Similarly, 23 into 1, 23, 80, then 20 into 4, 80, and so on. I will calculate the total of these fd dash x. It will comes out to be 64. Then I will calculate total of this fd dash x square. It will come out to be 236. Similarly, I will calculate the total of fd dash y and fd dash y square. Total of fd dash y is 20 and total of fd dash y square is 40. Now we have to calculate fd dash x, d dash y. How will we calculate fd dash x, d dash y? Here there are three values, frequency, d dash x, and d dash y. So we will multiply all the respective values, that is frequency, with its respective d dash x and d dash y. Here, frequency is 3 and respective d dash x is minus 2 and d dash y is minus 3. So multiplication of all these three values, 3 into minus 2 into minus 3 is 18. You can write down it with any other color, but in exams, you are not allowed to use any other color. So write down it in bracket or square or in circle to distinguish it from the frequency. Then 5 multiplied by minus 1 multiplied by minus 3. That is respective values. 5, its respective d dash x is minus 1 and respective d dash y is minus 3. 5 into minus 1, minus 5 into minus 3, 15. 4 into 0 into minus 3, 0. Then 0 frequency is not, if frequency is not given, then fd dash x, d dash y will be 0. Similarly, here it will be 0, here it will be 0, here we will calculate it as 3 into minus 2 minus 6 into minus 2, 12. 6 into minus 1 minus 6 into minus 2, 12. 6 into 0 into minus 2, it will be 0. 2 into 1 into minus 2, it will be minus 4. And here frequency is not given, then therefore it is 0. That means all the values for which d dash x is 0, that will be 0. All the values for which d dash y is 0, that will be 0. If frequency is not given, then all the values, all that values will be 0. And we will calculate all other values by multiplying the respective values. Like we will multiply 1 with minus 2. And minus 1, it will be 2. 4 into minus 1 into minus 1, it will be 4. 9 into 0 into minus 1, it will be 0. 5 into 1 into minus 1, it will be minus 5. And so on, we will calculate all the values. Now, we will find out total of these values of f d dash x, d dash y. In first row, f d dash x, d dash y is, first value is 18, the value is written in bracket, and second value is 15, and all other values are 0. So 18 plus 15, it is 33. 12 plus 0 plus minus 4 plus 0 plus 0. It is 12 plus 12, 24. Minus 4, it is 20. 2 plus 4 plus minus 5 plus minus 5. This will be minus 5 and minus 4, it is minus 9. And 2 plus 4 is 6. And 9 plus 6 is minus 3. Here it will be 0. And so on, we will calculate all the values. Then sum total of, we will find out total of f d dash x d dash y. It will comes out to be 125. Similarly, we can find out total from this side also, and that can be calculated to cross verify that there is no error in addition. That is, if you do the totaling row wise, there can be error. If you will total all, you will sum total all the values column wise also, then you can cross verify that total of row wise and column wise values is grand total of row wise and column wise values is same. Like here it is 125 and this is also 125. Now we will substitute all these values in the formula. This is the formula. Here it is group data, so we are also taking frequencies. N is sum total of frequencies, that is this 100 grand total. Then sigma f d dash x d dash y, this is 125 minus sigma f d dash x, this is 64. Then sigma f d dash y, this is minus 55. Sum total of this f d dash y. Then n sigma f d dash x square, n is 100. Sigma f d dash x square is 236 minus f sigma f d dash x whole square, sigma f d dash x is 64, and we will square this, we will find out square of the 64. Then 100 into 253 minus minus 55 square. The values will be this. We will solve the numerator, then denominator, divide that, and answer will be r is equal to minus 0.7. Positive 0.768. This is all about calculation or measurement of correlation with the help of Carl Pearson's coefficient of correlation in case of group data.